Hi and welcome back to Exploring Art. This is Alessandro. In the previous video, you can find the link in the description, we learned more about the enigmatic Gothic art. It developed during the medieval time as a new style of architecture and it rapidly spread beyond its origins to sculpture and painting in the whole Europe. Today we'll go deeper in the Gothic architecture features to understand the big innovations and impact Gothic has had in the creation of the huge cathedrals, like this one here.
It emerged in Île-de-France, the northern region that includes Paris, in the early 12th century and lasted until the 16th century. During that time, Gothic architecture was known as Opus Francigenum, French work. It started to be called Gothic, in fact, just during the Renaissance with the meaning of barbaric. Why that? Well, because this new style broke most of the classical rules in architecture, even if it was a Romanesque evolution. Already in the Basilica of Saint-Denis, the first example of Gothic architecture, we can easily understand how the main features were so innovative. And we need to start with the foundation, the pointed or ogival arch. It's an arch with a pointed crown whose two curving sides meet at a relative sharp angle at the top of the arch. Compared to the round arch, the pointed one allows to reach dramatically greater heights, making more space for windows. The combination of pointed arches led to the development of the pointed ribbed vault. The Gothic vault of pointed arches, unlike the semicircular vault of Roman and Romanesque buildings, can be used to roof rectangular and irregularly shaped plans. The other structural advantage is that the pointed arch channels the weight onto the bearing piers or columns at a steep angle. This enabled architects to raise vaults much higher than before. Furthermore, Gothic builders designed a new and lighter kind of rib vault that allowed to distribute the weight of the roof both downwards and outwards, and not just downwards like in the barrel vaults. But if some ribs go downwards as colonnettes and are bundled into pillars on the ground floor, other ribs carry the thrust outwards to the walls. These outward strengths are counterbalanced by heavy flying buttresses outside the walls, surmounted by pinnacles that are not mere decorations, but help the buttresses to have more strength, adding weight. Since the weight was supported by a skeleton of pillars and buttresses, the walls themselves could be much higher and thinner. That made possible the intense usage of stained glass that are another beautiful characteristic of Gothic cathedrals. The arches, vaults, and flying buttresses were combined in a plan that usually was following a scheme plan called Latin cross. A long nave is the body of the church that meets a transverse arm called transept, and beyond it, an extension which may be called choir, chancel, or presbytery. The area where the nave and transept meet is called the crossing, and it could be surmounted by a stone tower. The nave is generally flanked on either side by aisles, sometimes doubled, not only because natural extensions made by the buttresses, but also to give more internal space and magnificence to the entire building.
As you can see, the application of a simple element like the pointed arch made possible to revolutionize the architecture. And it's amazing thinking that a structural element was a consequence of such a lot of beauty. The ogival arch, in fact, makes possible to reach extreme heights. Combining many arches, builders obtained ribbed vaults that, at the same time, allowed to have more space for the windows that are another key feature in Gothic art, as well as the flying buttresses and their pinnacles. I know that's a lot of names and details, but now that we learned a lot more about the main Gothic features in architecture, in the next video we will see a beautiful application of them. You can also read the post on my website and find the pictures I showed you on my social medias. All the links are in the description, so stay curious and see you soon.